Okay, can't wait for you to get home. I'll heat you up some of the lasagna. My husband's voice suddenly cut off. I glanced at the phone. Emergency calls only, displayed almost as if mocking me. Strange. This area isn't normally a dead zone. I muttered to myself as I slipped my phone into the cup holder next to me. Probably for the best with this thick fog rolling in. I tried to enjoy the silence and focus on the road as I drove. This late at night, I hadn't seen any vehicles for miles and suspected that I was probably the only person driving in the area. The fog had started to grow thicker. I had just started to slow down for safety when I saw an old woman wandering along the road in front of me. I know you're not supposed to pick up hitchhikers, but I doubted anyone else would be along to help her anytime soon. Besides, she looked so frail, so tired that there couldn't be any harm in helping her a little. I called out my window as I stopped beside her. I can get you to the gas station. It's dark, and with this fog rolling in, someone might come along and not be able to see you. Thank you, sweetie. She smiled as she collapsed wearily into the passenger seat. You can call me Grandma. Everyone else does. Nice to meet you, Grandma. I introduced myself as the car began to pick up speed. I'm Marcy. If you want to turn the radio on, go right ahead. It's so hard to see, I dare not to take my eyes off the road enough to fiddle with the thing. There's no point in it. We wouldn't be able to pick up a radio station, even if you had a dashboard with an antenna. She laughed while she buckled herself with trembling hands. Perhaps we can just entertain ourselves the way that my grandparents did. What are you doing out so late, if I may ask? I explained that I was just on my way home after a long day at work. We'd had to stay late to finish a project. We then talked for a while about everything and nothing while we drove along that road. I was just starting to relax when Grandma gasped loudly as I flipped on my brights, hoping to see better. Don't do it. Grandma yelped. Just keep your lights on dim. You don't want to know what you can't see up there. Besides, the fog will just reflect the lights back and blind you. What are you talking about? I questioned as I glanced over at her. What do you mean by, don't want to know what you can't see? However, when I caught a glint on some twisted metal in the branches above, I hastily turned my lights back to dim. I was hoping to get you through this without you having known you were here. If I'm being completely honest with myself, I was hoping maybe I'd get out of here with you. Grandma sighed, and I saw her turn towards me in my peripheral vision. She took a few minutes to gather her thoughts before she spoke. I'm not sure what or where even this place is, but visibility is always limited. The terrain and weather changes just before a new driver comes through. I suspect it's to blend in with where the intended victim was located. I think it somehow feeds off the victims. I've seen a few others that were trapped turn bad. Though, you can get out. I've seen it done.
So, I'm not trapped, but I'm still caught in a kind of web, so to speak. I was skeptical. Sure, the terrain seemed a bit different than I was used to, but it was nighttime, foggy, and nobody actually pays that much attention to the scenery when they're focused on driving. Grandma chuckled softly.
Yeah, something like that. You're going to have to trust me if you want to make it out. Remember, I'm hoping to reach the other side with you.
Grandma took a deep breath and let out a sigh.
I'm so tired of being trapped here. Never getting to stop and rest. always on the move. I'm simply exhausted from it all.
I nodded, but checked my rearview mirror for any traffic, looking for a sign that things were somehow normal. That's when I noticed some shadows rushing back and forth in an angle across the road, following my car. Surprised, I quickly looked out my window and saw more running along my car a good distance from the road. Given the visibility, they were a little more than the vague shape of shadows.
Focus on the road, Marcy,
Grandma commanded.
Visibility is poor, and you don't want to get their attention too much. They're lost now. More lost than either you or I. But there's nothing you can do to help them.
Grandma paused before continuing.
I'm not even certain that you can help me, but they certainly won't help you. Keep your eyes ahead. If it makes you sleep better at night to think that they're just some dogs or your imagination, then by all means, please do so.
I tried. I really tried. It's like when someone says, quick, don't think of purple polka-dotted Dalmatians. And the only thing your mind can do now is think of purple polka-dotted Dalmatians. I couldn't help it. Every so often my eyes would drift up to the rearview mirror, partially out of habit, but mostly because I wanted to make sure they weren't getting any closer. Grandma loudly cleared her throat each time to get me to focus on the road ahead. Bless her heart. She tried so hard to keep me looking ahead and distracting me from my pursuers. I just couldn't keep my eyes ahead. Morbid curiosity, I guess. And I couldn't stop thinking about them. I didn't know what they were. I didn't know if they were safe. And each time, they just seemed a bit closer. You said that I am technically not trapped. Not yet, anyway. Grandma sighed.
If they catch up to you, like they did me, they'll destroy our only means of escape, and you'll be trapped with the rest of us. Then eventually we'll both be just as lost as they are.
Okay, but how do I escape? I questioned worriedly. My husband waited for me at home, probably worried about me since the call dropped on us. I wanted to get back to him and didn't want to think about either of us being without the other.
Isn't it obvious? I've been walking this road for I don't know how long. I've tried running away from the road, but I always come back to the road. Your car is the only way we will get out of this, and if you keep bringing the lost closer, we are both doomed.
Grandma snapped at me for looking back yet again. They were within two car lengths now, and I could almost make them out. They looked distorted, disfigured, and each one ran differently. Strangely, it seemed as if in becoming lost, they had forgotten how to run as they rapidly ran along behind us.
If you stop looking, they will get further away. I know it's the opposite of what our survival instincts say, but I've seen it work.
Grandma tried convincing me as she wrung her hands in her lap. I was suspecting that she didn't know for sure if that would work, and was just hoping it'd get me to finally stop looking back. I took a deep breath, trying to calm my nerves as I went around yet another bend in the road. Lights. There were lights ahead. Big, fat, beautiful, glorious lights. I was going to make it. Then the car shuddered and I looked down at the fuel gauge. Slightly over empty, my car began to slow down. But I had a decent speed going. If I could just coast the car long enough, I might make it to the light. Without slowing down or touching the brakes, I slammed my car in neutral. Maybe it damaged the transmission, but that wouldn't matter if I didn't escape. I could hear them, behind and beside me, as their limbs slapped the ground. It sounded like they were all around me, closing in and ready to make their move. I wanted to look, to see how close they were now. That light, so tantalizingly close. I looked at it as the salvation I believed that it was. Something slapped the trunk of my car. I held my breath and closed my eyes. Just a little further. You'll see your friends again. We're going to make it through, Grandma. I promised desperately, fearfully. Maybe it was a prayer. I waited until I felt the car come to a complete stop. Then I opened my eyes. Grandma was gone. There was no sign of the fog. No shadows behind my car. Everything seemed so normal, I could believe that I somehow dreamt the whole thing. Except, the passenger seatbelt was buckled. A small piece of evidence that I'd really picked up an elderly lady and survived. Something. If you drive alone at night, keep an eye out for the road. Grandma said the terrain and weather changed. I'm pretty sure it moves around and anyone can find themselves on it. Keep your gas tank full, because you'll never know when you may be caught on that road. Keep your lights on dim, stay in your car, and don't look back. Shout out to my superfans, Sweet Black Swan and Tacy. I really appreciate you guys supporting my channel, and I look forward to creating more content for everyone.